things that are being brought up by the people who were adults and parents at that time show a lot of denial. That's what I see, a lot of denial. At the end of the day, when it comes to the criminal child labor of myself and this other child, it wouldn't have been possible without Mary Kay. Because our abusive parents that dumped us there and forced us to work there, they had to go to Mary Kay for permission to do that. It wouldn't have been possible without her. She founded the place. She hired us. She's the one who said yes. She's the one who agreed to allow them to do this to us. They're still guilty, absolutely. But the people who try to say that this is just on the parents, it's not on Mary Kay, that's complete bullshit. It wouldn't have been possible without her. She had the ability and power the entire time to put an end to this and to not allow it to happen in the first place. She's the one who signed the paper. She's the one who hired us. She's the one who agreed to it. It would not have been possible without her, and she could have put an end to it at any moment. But what seems to have happened here is she has employees that abuse their children and some employees that don't abuse their children. And the ones that don't abuse their children don't let their kids work at criminal hours there. But the ones that do, she allows them to work us criminally. That's what it comes down to. They're all guilty. They're all responsible. One doesn't cancel out the other. No amount of legally worked teenagers can cancel out the minimum of the two of us that were criminally labored all those years. It doesn't cancel it out. It's nothing more than a distraction. It's denial. The fact that anybody's mind would even go to that. I've repeated it over and over again. I'll repeat it again. From 10 to 17 was all illegal. The first 4.5 years, automatically illegal for my age. From 15 to 17, illegal because I was being worked over the legal hours allowed, by far over the legal hours allowed, and deprived of an education still. That makes it criminal. I don't know what else to say to that. I don't know how else to answer that. None of these things that are brought up, teens that were illegally worked there, why would I bring them up? If they weren't being illegally worked there, that's why I'm very specific. Criminally child labored, and any others that may have been criminally labored there. You can't criminally labor two kids and say it doesn't matter. And that's your problem. That's the problem with the mentality as a whole. That we don't matter because right now, all we know of, there's just the two of us. It's just us two. We don't matter like the rest. Mary Kay had me removed for the 6 months because what she was doing was criminal and she knew it. Fast forward to 15. I'm 15 now, which means they can legally work me 20 hours a week. If I'm being educated, if school is done first, if these other needs are being met, which they weren't, but let's just set that part aside. 15 to 17, I was in that building between janitorial services and working there more than 50 plus hours a week there later than any other person or adult in that building besides Mary Kay some nights. There was a long period of time where they started having me clock out early or clock in late, but still work because they were trying to hide just how many hours and how much work I was doing there. So it was illegal from 10 to 14 and a half, and it was illegal from 15 to 17. I was worked well over, double to more than double, the legal hours for a 15-year-old to work. It was all illegal. It's still criminal. What you've done is still criminal. So I would say if we separate it, why is your mind even going there when I'm talking about a 6 to 10-year-old, from 6 to 10 years old, and then me from 10 to 14 and a half? Why are you focusing on 15 and 17 when I'm telling you there was a 6-year-old being worked here? Why is your mind going to that? All criminal, 100%, for that child and myself. I don't care what other kids you worked there legally that weren't being abused. For me and this other child, it was 100% criminal, 100% illegal, and justice has not been paid, and these people have not even acknowledged or shown any remorse for what they've done or participated in or watched happen. Everyone may not know all the details of how or why or exactly how it all came together, but I'll tell you right now, there is more than meets the eye here. The connection between these people in authority, these people who took over these organizations, some of them that are still running it, there is a connection, and it's not just, oh, we happen to be neighbors and became friends. That's what I'm telling you. I may not have all the details, but I have enough, and there's a lot y'all haven't seen yet, and you haven't heard yet. There's plenty you haven't heard and seen from other survivors. So stop trying to cancel out an evil that was done by somebody simply because they didn't do that evil to every child that was worked at CN. One person stepping up to enforce a labor law at the time does not cancel out all of those years and how it has affected the rest of our lives, those of us who were, that have come forward and that have not come forward yet. It does not cancel it out. You don't get a sticker for finally following the law at some point. You were supposed to be doing it the whole time, but you want a sticker because maybe now you don't have anybody being criminally labored there. It was supposed to be that way in the first place. You don't get a sticker. Beginning to do what you were supposed to do from the very beginning. You don't get a reward for that.
White Zom in the stogie, stood firm, never folded. Furthest thing from a rotor, you put the jacket on and you bogus. Yeah, big dog and they know it, I had to spin off to stay focused. Long jab on emotion, we on the bandit ship when it's hopeless.